Hello friends, welcome to the lecture series of Python programming. In this lecture series you will get all the lectures on different topics of Python programming. You will be able to write Python code step by step. So to get notifications of my next lectures, please press on bell icon and subscribe my channel. Today I am going to give some basic introduction to Python programming. These are the outlines of the today's lecture. Very first, I will be delivering very first what is Python. Second, the features of Python. Then compiling and interpreting Python code. Then Python installation, the Jupyter notebook with Anaconda in Windows. So let's start with what is Python. Python is interpreted high level and general purpose programming language, which is more better than all other programming languages like C, which is procedure oriented programming language, C++ and Java, which are the object oriented programming languages. Python supports multiple programming paradigms such as object-oriented, imperative, functional, and procedural. It means the programmer can write the program based on any one of the programming approach that I discuss over here. Very first, object-oriented, imperative, functional, and procedural. The Python was introduced by Guido van Rossum at CWI, Netherlands, in late 1989. Today I am going to discuss the basic features of Python. Very first, Python having the concept of dynamic type. It means data type is set as per the data value assigned to the identifier or the variable. Second, automatic memory management. It supports the garbage collection. Whatever the values are not longer required for any one of the Python type object, those Python objects will be automatically releasing the memory, and it is considered as a garbage collection that will be helpful for later uses. Third, Python is a platform independent. The code written in Python can be run on any platform. It can be run on Windows, or it can be run on Linux, or any Sun microsystem, or any kind of platform the Python code be executable. Fourth is scalable. It is having pluggable and modular architecture for scalability. It means the existing Python code can import the modules which already have been developed, so it saves the time that is no longer required for creating the code again and again. Next one is extensible. One module code can be accessed by other module too. Python is easy to learn, read and maintain. Python is also very robust programming language. It supports the rapid prototyping tool, so it is more effective as a rapid prototyping tool. Now this is the basic difference between the compiling and interpreting of Java code and the Python. Very first is, if we are having the source code in Java file, that is .java file, very first it is compiled which generates the bytecode, that is .class file. Once .class file is generated, it is a bytecode, can be executed on any other platform which needs the interpretation, and it gives the output. It means many languages require to compile the source code to the machine readable form. For example, as I discussed, .java code needs to be compiled into .class file, then it will be executed. While in case of Python, directly interpretation is there. It means our source code, which is .py file, that is Python file, directly executed and gives the output. That means Python is directly interpreted into the machine readable form. Next is Python installation, that is Jupyter Notebook with Anaconda in Windows. For this Python installation, Jupyter Notebook with Anaconda, I already created one video and you can visit to my video. So you can visit my video for Python installation with Jupyter Notebook in Anaconda. Below is the link given over here that you can visit for this particular video for installation of the Jupyter with Anaconda. Thank you.